before. I've been, sorry, two headphones in, I feel all muffled. I've been kind of reviewing games for nearly 11 years now. The 2nd of May 2006 was when I started. So 2nd of May next month will be 11 years exactly since I started reviewing games for a living. So yeah, and in that time I must have done about 1,000, mostly because O&M was full of. When I worked at Official Nintendo Magazine, I got a lot of Virtual Console and WiiWare stuff to do, so that kind of bumped the numbers up. So yeah, counting small reviews, probably about 1,000 games in 11 years. Start with Iron Brew. Most recently, I've just finished reviewing 19 Switch games this month, which was a bit off a bit more than I could chew there, but it went well, so that's good. I'm quite happy with that. So I'm just moving the mic a bit. So yeah, so today, hello, Ib Simpson. Thanks very much. Hope you enjoy it. Let me just move my setup a bit here, just so I've got my keyboard nearer, and I can bring the mic round. Does that work? That's probably best, because I've never done a thing like this before. So yeah, I just figured that since I get loads of messages and stuff from people asking, essentially how reviews work. Let me just bring up a separate chat window so that I can see it better. You missed absolutely nothing.
Essentially how
The first 10 seconds are
reviews work.
famously the worst. Yeah, I was watching Hall of Fame, good old Kurt Angle. So yeah, I've never actually shown the process before, and I always get kind of money, and I always get a kind of emails and stuff from people saying, how do I write, how do I improve my writing and stuff like that. And the short answer is there's no real, I can't tell you how to do it because everyone's got their own unique style. Everyone does the process completely differently. So this by no means should you treat today as some sort of tutorial, and you might pick up some tips if we're both massively lucky. But for the most part, it's more just showing my process for like kind of transparency. It's one of the good things about having my site Tyro Hack now is that I don't kind of answer to anyone, and there's no kind of need to. Not that other games journalists are hiding anything. That's definitely not how it works. But just processes and all that don't need to be secret now. So I can pretty much show you the entire thing. And if you've ever wondered how I structure a review or anything like that, or how I write one, I tend to write reviews relatively quickly. And while it might not be as quick today because I'll be stopping to talk and answer questions and stuff, hopefully you'll get an idea of how after 11 years, I've learned to kind of structure stuff and do all that kind of shit. So yeah, hopefully you get something out of it. If you're enjoying it, please share it with people and jump on various social networks of choice and say, look what this dick's doing, he's fucking reviewing a game live, what a twat. Let's all go and shout abuse at him while he tries to while he hits a mental block and forgets what to write next. So that'd be lovely. So yeah, let's get cracking. I downloaded it last night. I had a test stream up last night where I was checking everything worked, and so anyone who was on that last night would have seen me seen the test stream where I actually bought and downloaded the game. Just the setup for before we get going, just so people know, we've got Monomill. We've got I can't remember if I already said Monomill, but I'll say that now. So we've got the main screen here, obviously showing the game and stuff like that. We've got the main webcam, which I don't think we'll ever use because no one needs to see me that big. Although I do like pointing out the Virtual Boy there, just for the sake of showing off. The game is Virginia on Xbox One. So yeah, we've got that. That's the setup here. I'll never really use this probably. I've got the game, the full game itself, full screen, maybe for cutscenes or stuff like that or whatever. Again, I'm not sure I'll use that mainly. You'll mostly be seeing this for the first maybe 2 hours. Apparently, that's how long the game takes to beat. I've cho deliberately chosen a short game so you're not sitting here all day. And so I'm not sitting here all day. So yeah, for the first 2 hours or so, you'll mostly be seeing this and me occasionally switching to this second screen, which is where I've got my notes ready. So yeah, at this point I've got kind of anytime something happens, blah blah blah, type my notes, and then go back to the game. Just so you can get an idea, I mean it's slightly slower than how I would usually do it. I'd usually have a laptop in front of me, or I'd have a notebook or something, or if I desperately had to, I'd just keep it in my head. But I don't really kind of like doing that if I can help it. So it'll be a slightly slower process because I'll need to pause each time and switch to this second screen and then type and switch back. But just for the sake of transparency and so you can see how it's done, I'll take that extra step today. So apologies if a couple of times I start typing stuff and forget that I haven't switched over. I'll do my best to switch over and let you see what I've written. So yeah, shall we get cracking with the old Virginia? And I promise I won't call it vagina too often because that's not even the best of jokes. So here we go. At any point, let me know how the sound levels are. If I'm too loud or too quiet, or the game's too loud or too quiet, let me know. This is usually now where the Xbox One crashes and it all goes on its arse. Hopefully not. How are we all this morning? Are we all? I didn't get much of a sleep, so it should be entertaining as it goes on. Are we all fighting, fit, and tip top, enjoying our weekends? It's taking a while, isn't it? I was joking about it crashing, but it actually might. Oh no, there we go. We used to joke that. They won't like me for saying this. I used to joke that. We used to joke in the office that 505 games were called that because they released 505 games a year. There was a period where they just churn out any old shite, but their output seems to be getting better, to be fair to them. Press A to take a trip. Let's do it. I have not played this, just for the record. Obviously, this is the whole point of it. I've seen vague kind of people saying you should play this, and I maybe watched like a trailer when it was first announced, but that is literally it. I don't know. All this is new to me, which is kind of the point. A real pro always checks the settings. Not really, but. Let's have subtitles on just so. In case I'm talking shite and you can't hear what's actually going on in the story. Any in-game tips? Invert look, yep. So, action. Oh, that's it. Turn move in action. Ah, easy enough. Right, let's do a letter from the creators. I wonder if I'll leave that till the end. I don't want it. In case it's got spoilers in it, I don't want to. Let's do it. Morning, Purple Chimp. I'm not the sort of person who talks during streams like that, it's really annoying. I should probably take a note of that. Just in case. Anyway. Nice, I like the art style so far. If the game's like that, I'm in for a treat. Mystique. Not sure I like the character design. This isn't an April Fool's prank, it's just this is the only day that I could get. Oh, this is the game, okay. Yeah, I'm not sure I'm a massive fan of the character design, but okay. I mean, I'll write that now, it might grow on me, but. For now, the first impressions are just like. Bleh. Can I pause this? Yes, that's good. It's always more helpful when I can pause. Okay, so it's like point and clicky. It does look like an Easter Island head. I might steal that later. Oh, Lippy, do I get to apply it? No, I don't. Oh, so it's first person, okay. It's a very angular toilet, it might cut your arse to ribbons. Let's move on. Speaking to someone who said this gave them motion sickness, I can kind of see where that would happen. Where the fuck? Can I just. It's not a good start when I can't even get out the fucking room. I've no idea what this game's about, that's why I've chosen it. Oh, this is brilliant. What a start. Stuck in a fucking room. And you can't open this? Oh, you can. It just didn't decides not to give a button prompt this time. Good. Can I speed up the speed that I turn at? Alright, see you, mate. I don't know the difference between turn and look is, but there we go. I don't think it's a horror game from what I can gather. I think it's more a mystery type thing. I don't think there's scares or anything like that in it, from what I gather. It takes me 2 hours to get out the door. So I can't get in there, okay. Well, presumably these doors are locked, so. And I'm not messing up opening the door again. It's pretty atmospheric though, fair play to it. Oh, there's people there. Check this door. Yeah, I wasn't keen on the character design at first, but I think it's just the lead character. I don't like the rest, kind of look okay. Oh, I see, the dot turns into a diamond when you can do something. That's a bit too subtle for my liking. See, it's now a diamond, so I can step forward. Thanks, Day of Grace. I appreciate that. Cheers, mate. So everyone applaud me for doing my first ever live review. I mean, I wasn't expecting that sort of thing. It's not that big a deal. Got me. You got me. Zing. I wish that subtitle hadn't said minor heartbeat monitor, because I didn't actually know that's what it was. So, can't get it there. This is good. It's a wee bit. Oh, here we go. Okay, I can't move, so I'm going here by the looks of it. Pretty linear so far. I'm not really having it seems just like a kind of straight path that I'm going down. Like if the dot doesn't become like a circle or a diamond like it just did there on that door, then you can't really do anything else. It's almost like it's always kind of forcing you towards one path. Like, I'd like to be able to open that fridge and see what's in it, or turn the tap on at least. It's kind of basic stuff to give you the impression that there's like a degree of interactivity, that you're in this world and not just in a load of different box rooms that don't actually do anything. All this stuff is all this is like the only thing I can do is go through this door. Alright, bud. Ooh. I wonder if I'll leave that if it eventually goes to 531. Let's do it. Let's wait and see if it goes to 5. Let's give it a minute and see if it goes to 531. Check my Twitter. Actually, fuck that. It's going to take too long. I literally can't be bothered waiting a minute to see if that goes to 531. Oh. Yeah, the subtitles are a bit over the top, aren't they? The music's fantastic. I'm glad I took a note of who did it. These notes all seem kind of random just now, but that's kind of the process. Once we're done with the game, the next step is kind of trying to fit them all together to make them kind of join together. A lot of kind of reviews, kind of iffy reviews, will, not that I'm slagging anyone off, but kind of entry level people who are just starting off writing reviews will kind of, there's a bad habit that a lot of people do, which is just taking a list of things, you know, it does this and it does this and it does this and it does this, and then that's the review and then in conclusion. But if you can kind of join them together, kind of like a jigsaw, to make all the points flow together, then That's the trick. Oh, I've actually got an option now, pick up the badge or pick up the lipstick. I bet I can do both. Hey! What's fuck all wrong with that lipstick, mate? Oh well. What's her name? Anne? Still can't interact with anything, which is, that disappoints me initially, that it looks like these notes are all negative just now, but I'm curious about it actually. Yeah, the music's great. I wonder if the subtitles available. That's maybe something I need to investigate. I think she did. You're just checking to see if there's, for continuity's sake. Leaning over as if I can see. I don't see lipstick in the bin. Maybe it was a paranormal thing. Oh, can I see my name here? Anne. It starts with a T, but I don't know. Anyway, let's go. Let's get the fuck out of this bathroom. Yeah, that's true. I need to see more of the characters though, because for now, yeah, lead character design's a bit meh. For now, I want to see more characters before I decide, because I only really got a brief glimpse of people there. Then I need to get kind of closer to more folk to see if all the characters are a bit meh. Okay. Yeah, it's almost, I don't know if the whole game's going to be like this, but it's kind of, it is just kind of leading you by the hand the whole time, because this dot becomes a circle. So you, basically each room at this point seems to be a case of look around until a circle appears. Oh, there we go, that's what I'm headed for. So it's like there's no kind of game element to it, it's just like an interactive story at this point, which is fine if that's what it is. But that's something that if the game continues like this, I'm going to have to point out in the review. Like, if you're expecting an actual puzzle here, you're not going to get one. This is like a more an interactive movie. Okay. Monday. Not very dramatic. This is really cinematic. Hello, Dara. It's interesting the way it cuts from scene to scene, like a film does. These games don't really do that usually. Music's fucking tremendous. I was going to say it all looks really old school, but I forgot to say that they start set in summer 1982, didn't it? Right, what am I circling in on this time? Right, let's get a better look at the character design here then. Hello, Paolo Di Canio. It looks okay actually, it is just the main character looks a bit weird. Yeah, it could maybe. I mean, it might. Maybe the fact that it keeps seemingly looks like it kind of jumps from scene to scene might be a bit disconcerting in VR. Yeah, I think it's just the lead character who looks a bit shit. These other guys all look kind of normal. She looked strange. This Poindexter.
Yes.
Yeah, I should probably clarify that then. Maybe overdoing it a wee bit, but whatevs. That was Roger Federer there, right? Roger Federer working on a computer. Good for him. Right, let's see. Is this where we're going? She moves really slowly, but I suppose that's to... She's not going to be sprinting through the office, is she? Go, there's a circle. All right, Mrs. Janine from Ghostbusters. Yep. Sorry about the fact that every time I switch to the notes, the chat kind of disappears. That's just a quirk of the software I'm using. I can't really fix that, I'm afraid. So I'm sorry that everyone... I'm getting all your chat on a separate window, so don't worry. I'm not just seeing what you can see here. I've got the full chat, so don't worry about your messages disappearing. I'm still getting them. Well, hello, Cord McCarran. It's like a baby with a moustache. I can't do anything, it's not... I must sit down, yeah. Take your seat, weird looking lady. That's me. Oh no, it's not me. This is Maria. Maria someone. Oh, so I'm investigating someone else. Really, what's the point of subtitles if no one's talking in this? I want this soundtrack. Let's go nowhere, let's go nowhere. From the GameCube library, definitely Mary Kate and Ashley's Sweet 16 Ready to Drive. That's definitely the one to play for an April Fool. This is like, it's really cinematic. Oh, okay. Definitely, that was, I don't know if I like that, but yeah, it fits in with the whole cinematic thing. It's quite clever. It's trying like kind of cinematic tricks, like jump cuts and stuff that games wouldn't usually do. Take a note of that because it's weird. I think I better reword that later, but yeah, basically games don't, you know, games are all usually scared to mess about with the, not the narrative, but I'm trying to say, the timeline basically like that, as regularly as that, because it throws the player off, whereas movies, a lot of movies do it. So that's a cool move. Hello, person. Make sure I get. Oh, who's this? What's the haps? Haircut. Well, that's the woman I'm investigating. Pack your stuff, mate. Why am I in the car? I'm investigating her, but I'm in the car with her. She does seem shifty. Oh. 28 points, that's a bit pretentious. I really like how it looks now. I was put off by the character design, but I like the look. Kingdom. Now, not having read any reviews of this, I get the feeling most of the reviews of this mention Twin Peaks, and that might be the angle to go with, even though it's obvious, especially if that's cherry pie, but it isn't. Well, there's coffee though. Twin Peaks would be the obvious reference, especially if everyone else is kind of assuming that everyone else has done the same thing. Oh, where the fuck did she go? But sometimes the most obvious references are the ones to kind of go with. Especially with Twin Peaks coming back, that's maybe the angle to go with. Hello, beard. Keep your head down, mate, they're crying. Oh, I forgot I could move. I thought I was just standing there because I was sitting in the last scene and then realised I could move this time. I'm afraid your nose is falling off. You're going to have to keep holding it still. That's right. Keep doing that. Officer. The amount of detail that's gone into these environments, but then doesn't let you do anything. Even just letting me open this wardrobe, and even if it was just clothes in it, but just kind of be an extra wee. That's true, Paramount, very well said. Even just being able to see some clothes would just be a nice kind of touch. Even if it didn't actually mean anything, it would just add to the sense that you were in an actual place and not just a series of boxes. There's absolutely nothing I can do here in this entire kitchen. It's not, the icon isn't changing. I can't open the microwave, can't pick that up, can't turn the tap on, can't open the fridge again. It's stuff that doesn't mean anything, but it would just be nice stuff to play about with. especially if by all accounts the game's really short, it would kind of artificially extend the length of the game a wee bit if you can piss about with stuff, open the window and do all that kind of stuff, flush the toilet. That's a, I've been flushing toilets in games since the 90s for a cheap kick. I know that's a minor thing to moan about, but no, it's like an open one wardrobe. And see clothes in it. They're obviously listening to me. I'll switch my headphones. I've got a sore ear. Right. Oh. He's got a scud dungeon. That music, man, that sounded like the Goonies. Bit in the Goonies when they see the pirate ship, that kind of, it's that same vibe, that music. I think I can do it here. What are these photos? Oh, cheeky wee water tower. Laddie and his bird. And the music's fantastic. I need to, that's my first point of research after playing it, is for part of the review, is to see whether the soundtrack's available. It might be one of those rare situations where even while writing the review of the game, also kind of recommend that people get the soundtrack even if they don't care about the game. Right, Lucas. There's also going to be a tricky one to review because I don't like to give away plot spoilers, and this game's all fucking plot so far. Here you. Bison. See if she's diesel or unleaded or 4-star. Oh, so I'm investigating it at this point. I couldn't figure out whether it was going back in time or anything like that. I thought this was maybe a flashback, but I wonder if I'm investigating her at this point or if I've not yet got the dossier saying investigate her. Oh, she's got two names. What's that distant pop music I can hear? Is that the guy? That's the guy who was missing. Who are you, prick? Right, let's take a screenshot there. Forgotten. Should we be getting screenshots? Xbox One. Well, all systems these days are great for taking screenshots on the fly. Switch is the best I've seen so far. Because it's instant. Xbox One is almost as instant. In fact, Xbox One is pretty much as good. It's just not as easy to get the screenshots when you're done with them. PlayStation 4 lags behind a tiny wee bit, I think, because when you press the button, there's a delay between you pressing the button and it saying it's captured the screen. And once it's captured the screen, you kind of have to wait for the wee icon to disappear from the top before you can capture another one. But if I captured screenshots as I'm playing this, you'll see the process later where I grab them off the Xbox app. on PC, which is a really useful wee app for grabbing your screens. So was that him, that Lucas guy? Was that who I saw give me the finger in the, so to speak, in the car in the petrol station? Oh wait, that's Mina. Is it? How am I not? Who am I now then if I'm not me? Is someone come into her room? Yeah, I'm a man now. That's definitely a Twin Peaks style kind of feel to it. I don't like having to say it because it seems too obvious, but it might be the opening paragraph and the conclusion are always the hardest bits to write, but that might be my way in with Twin Peaks starting next month. I mean, it's pretty blatantly get a Twin Peaks feel to it. Oh, there's a guy who was... Oh, I'm really confused now. So who was missing if it wasn't him? This is the problem when you've got kind of basic character design, is that a lot of the characters look kind of similar. Seems a bit severe. Oh, I'm in with the driving a car with a baby faced moustache. Oh fuck! Fuck is going on here now. It was 92, it was allowed. I've no idea what's going on. It's baby-faced assassin. Hello? Oh, this is like the new It trailer. Grace Jones. Oh, hold on a minute. I'm not really sure what's going on here. I don't know if I'm just being stupid or if it's deliberately confusing at this point. Like the delayed Grace Jones. That's a good screenshot for the top image. on the review. You'd be kind of thinking of these stuff as well, and at the same time as what can be kind of used for. Pardon me, actually, maybe this one here. If I put the dot over this golf ball shaped thing in the middle so that you can't be seen really, that's a good screenshot for the lead image at the top of the review. I mean, usually when you're doing reviews and previews and stuff, you'll be given pressed screens by the PR, but that's only really kind of last resort. Ideally, you want to be taking your own screen so you're kind of in control of showing what the game actually looks like, and getting more of a choice over specific bits to show off. A lot of times PRs will kind of give you kind of upscaled shots taken from a PC dev kit, or bits with the, not that it matters here in this game, but bits with the heads up display kind of removed and stuff like that. Oh, now it's like Stranger Things. This is obviously before Stranger Things, so yeah, it's just a coincidence. Yeah, I'm the same. Go Go Gadget, Go Goat. I've no idea what's going on, but I'm into it. What? Is that bats? No, it's birds. See, that's just begging to be played, especially with all the music that's in this game. Can't be played. Can't be played. That's the main disappointment for me so far. Is that I'm doing nothing basically. This game's just leading me by the hand. Hello there, board. We turn the subtitles off because they're totally pointless and they're just getting in the way of my screenshot taking. I didn't realise there was no actual dialogue in it. Oh, fuck! Well, that's awkward. Should probably take this moment before I enjoy this warm mug of Joe to say that if you're enjoying this, feel free to kind of share it on your social media, forum, Reddit or whatever of choice, because it's obviously going to be going on for a few more hours yet, well, when it comes to writing the review and stuff, so the more the merrier, as to say. Oh, she's alright. That was a nice wee reveal there. Get that fucking mug of Joe down you, mate. You'll be alright. Madam. Actually, I don't even understand the achievements. I don't understand what. Is she actually drinking any of this? Mate, I'm drinking my fucking coffee. He's shit. Either that's a different guy or he's shaved. Is this the morgue? If they send one of yours to the hospital, you send two of theirs to the morgue. You got Sean Connery there for you. Oh. This is. Why would you put a bird on a fucking slab in a morgue? Bird's alright, don't worry, pyromaniac. I wish I had the subtitles on so I could tell that that was distant pop music. A boombox, eh? This guy really doesn't like me. Whoa, whoa, steady on, mate. Oh, you're right, the bird was on the logo. Yeah, good job. What's your face? You prick. I only just put that on 4 flashbacks ago. You're under arrest for ripping a chain off. Fucking typical vapor. Oh wait, it's a knife. Thought it was a vape. A wallet, eh? Was this money to buy vape? It's a nice wee angular screenshot there. Stuff like this when you can't turn off that wee dot in the middle. You try and hide it so the screenshot looks a bit better. Tricks of the trade. You playing it, missus? This is the perfect game for YouTube streamers because they don't have to do any edits in the video. You know, you get these ones where someone plays a game for 4 hours and then edits it together into like a 30-minute video. They don't need to do that here because the fucking cuts are all made for them. See, that was just a totally pointless room. It's so annoying. I can't decide whether I love it or I'm annoyed by it, because that entire room I was just in there was a complete waste of time. It set the scene and that was it. Like, there was nothing to do in it, and there'd be nothing to do in this one except for one thing, which in this case seems to be the bed. It is literally, this could have just been one big hour and a half, 2 hour cutscene without me really doing much. That's true, that's very deep. What is that? Let's take a note of that. Where's it? Interactivity. Yeah, it does seem like, yeah, it would be a better suit to VR, but it'd be a lot of motion sickness. I wouldn't be able to play this in VR, because it would make me motion sick. So there's that. Maria, that's the one that I'm investigating, apparently. Rest in peace, George Michael. Sense another cut. There we go. Oh shit. That's getting a bit freaky deaky now. Bird gets everywhere, Matt. The story's heating up now. Very good. Strong. Wit. So you mean to tell me she told someone their nose was falling off? What a prick. Grace Jones was good in that one Conan film. Was it Conan or was it Red Sonja she was in? That's what she looks like, Grace Jones in whatever one that was. 80s era Grace Jones. Anne Tarver. Let me just take a note of that. Just in case I don't get a chance to see the character's name again. Yeah, it didn't seem much. It's not that hard, but it was probably just as well for a review stream that I don't get stuck in it, but yeah, it's weird. She not have done this at the start? Maybe she has done this at the start and this is just a flashback to when she was... Yeah, she's got two names. See, all this... I'm just pressing the A button here. It'd be brilliant if you could like have a bit more interactivity with this search. This is doing all the figuring out for you. A cheeky microfiche. So she the mum of the woman I'm trying to track? Yes, it's the 60s. So she must have given birth to her that I'm tracking now. And then she's changed her name from Ortega to something else. Get that knob turned, mate. Oh, she's gone all X-Files. Oh. She's really good at finding exactly where she's supposed to go. Oh, it's fucking Grace Jones. Oh, so the locket's her mum, presumably. So has he gone missing because she killed him? I do like the way it cuts from scene to scene really quickly. There's not been a single loading time in this game. Upstairs. It's a shame because it's just essentially the whole game is consists of walking about waiting for the cursor to change to a circle. So what do we think of Virginia so far? Are we pleasantly surprised by it? Are we a bit confused by it? Is it the future of interactive entertainment? Yeah, it's pretty much where I'm at just now as well. Especially right now, where I don't know where I'm supposed to go next. Was it through here after all? Yeah, I'm hoping there'll be some kind of illuminating bit at some point when you go, oh, okay. Yeah, it's... Oh, there we go. Yeah, I'm not sure I'm a fan of the just kind of walking about. Alright, see you in a bit, mate. Have some of that ginger. Ed Sheeran's raging. weird. There are some kind of nice effects. Not that these are the greatest shadows in the world, but when you consider it's such a kind of basic looking game, not basic, but kind of minimalist style, it's odd that this thing goes to kind of detail with these leaves and stuff. It's a bit severe, mate. Can I just handcuff them? Alright. She's broken into that house. Cheeky bastard. Oh, a book. Music is always kind of just and no more threatening to be the X-Files theme tune, but then changes. It is more like an interactive film, isn't it? I mean, it's probably ideal for the purposes of this live review. I'm not. Other than that bit in the toilet at the start, there's no real chance of me getting stuck in it, so I can play through it easily enough. That music, though. That's Twin Peaks style. Listen to it. Are they a couple? Oh, look at this. That is blatant Twin Peaks style music. Even the bar's kind of similar to the one in the second series of Twin Peaks, where they have the beauty contest. Yeah, what was the thing? What am I looking at here? Oh, that geezer. Yeah, fuck off. As if you didn't see me just putting that on. It's my emergency ring for any time someone's giving me hassle. Thank you. skills. It looks ridiculous. I really like this style. Where's my key? Good job, I saw that. This was, I'll need to double check for a review, but I'm sure it was £7.99. I get a feeling it's £7.99, $9.99, but I'll need to double check that before I write the review, because that needs to go at the end of the review. But I'm sure it's, when I bought it last night, I'm pretty sure it was £7.99. Yeah, it's decent when you consider films. I'm gonna make that point actually before I forget it. I mean, how long has this been playing now? An hour and 15 minutes. So we're at the bottom level of what would be considered film length. Films cost twice this. Can I go out there? Probably not. Look at that. Through the window, that's cool. I like that. The game in question is called Virginia, or Virginia, depending how you want to pronounce it, on Xbox One. I think it's also on PC and PlayStation 4. Shh, 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 shh. sure where to go next. There's a problem. It's one of these games where there's just one thing it's waiting for me to click on. There it is. She's just a weird looking main character. I think it's the hair. The hair's off-putting. Oh, I never saw Assassin's Creed. It sounds like I didn't miss much though. So where in the shit am I going? The old wakey wakey eggs and bakey. Oh. Yeah, it looks fantastic, doesn't it? Let's try and get another good screenshot here. Excellent. Jesus Christ. Stick a wee gallery in the article, I think, because it looks that good. Not a slideshow gallery, because I don't roll that way, because I'm not in that clickbait shit, but we'll think of a way to get multiple screenshots in here. There's something here that highlighted. There we go. The old toast. Yeah, it's pretty much is point and clicky. Yeah, it is. That's exactly what it is, in fact. It's a point and click, but with no puzzles. More like a point-and-click movie rather than a point-and-click adventure, because there's no real adventure involved. You're just kind of following the path. Here now. Yeah, there's not been a single puzzle yet, and by all accounts, going by what people say, it might only be another half an hour or so before the game's beaten, so. I don't know, unless a puzzle turns up at the end, we're puzzle free. Good old days when you had to develop films instead of just looking at them on a digital camera. A bit dangerous to have that fluid in your hands, I would have thought. Fuck is this? No idea what's going on. Oh, Ed Sheeran's been locked up. Oh, is he cheating on someone? Correct. Nah, he's out. Mate? You shagging about? Right, so here we go. That's That's right, it was bombing it down the road. See you later, mate. Wainwright, another fucking 14 top 20 hits. Scalp. He's like, mate, it doesn't matter if you did comic relief, you're still a prick. What's going on? So she's shagging Sheeran then? She's shagging Sheeran. What even is that? Oh, it's a picture. Someone in cuffs? No, there's no dialogue at all. Oh, right, so it's this. Problem, arsehole. Cheeky wee sandwich. Keep you going, eh? Sitting there all day. I see you playing it. Are they all going up to that, to the observatory thing? Let's roll. FBI, motherfucker, let us into the house. We can't just say no. Mate, you've just put diesel in a fucking unleaded car, mate. What's the bison thing? Buffalo, whatever it is. Why are you buying that? Why are you playing it? More cuts and snipper clips, nice. No, that's her file. Who is this? Throw the buffalo at her and run like fuck. To be fair, mate, you're a sour-faced bastard, so no wonder they're investigating you. Drama. Actual drama. It's not that obscure. It's certainly not for people my age. It's not that obscure, but that's a good shout. It's, they do look very Dire Straits money for nothingy. Suppose it's obscure for the young bucks out there, but yeah, I got it. Yeah, still, I mean, if it helps Pyromaniac, from what I gather, it only takes about 2 hours to beat, so it looks like we're probably coming towards the end of it. Because I've not really been stuck too often, and from what I've heard other people say, you're talking 2 hours to beat it, so we must be coming to the end. Yeah, I think that's the case, Dara. It's like, if it was more detailed, yeah, there would be loading times and stuff. But stuff like that, yeah, you wouldn't have been able to manage. You wouldn't have been able to manage that if it was detailed. This is back at the start now. And I was getting cheered for something. This is me joining the FBI? £2 for £8, but it's more the experience rather than the. Right, okay. Presumably Friday's the last day, but fuck me. Yeah, exactly. It's short, but it's, and if it was 40 quid, there'd be an issue there, but I'm certainly not going to forget it anytime soon, so I've got my money's worth. I think the experience is born maybe because you're not playing it. I think watching someone play it is different. Not that I'm doing a hell of a lot, but just that extra level of interactivity is maybe keeping me going. But I mean, each to their own, like, you could be controlling it and probably still be bored as well. I mean, it's just, it's whatever. Yanks your crank. I'm really enjoying it. I think my review is going to be a fairly positive one. It's got plenty of negative points, which I'll point out, but I think it's going to be one of those weird reviews where it's like, if you don't mind this kind of thing, go for it. It's going to be one of those, not everyone's going to like this efforts. In other words, one of those annoying reviews that isn't definitive. Sorry, when it's Zelda and you can say everyone buy this, but something like this is very much an acquired taste, but I seem to have acquired that I quite like it. You're asking for trouble here, mate. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to agree to disagree there. I don't like people who try to become the star of the show on a stream. I get some people like that, but I can't watch people. I can't watch things like that when people put on funny accents and read out the text and all that. I can't watch those. But that's me. What's happening here? Is this maybe how it ends? I don't get the significance of that amulet, the locket thing. That's her mum, is it not? The woman I'm investigating, is it her mum? It's the picture of her in the locket. Yeah, Grace Jones. It's her mum. Still, bits this I don't understand. I don't understand the bit where, for like 20 seconds, I was controlling a different guy in her bedroom, leaving the room. I didn't get that bit. Break it down. Oh, I'll pick the lock. Yeah, maybe a bit mistaken, but I would say that it's been like this all the way through. There has been like a plot, but I'm struggling to follow it, if I'm being honest. It might take a couple of, not that I'll play through it a couple of times today, but it might take a couple of playthroughs to kind of get my head around it. This bastard then, if I've got a lockpick. It's a nifty wee tool. Oh, it's a shame that people watching it, I'm actually quite enjoying it. Oh well, so that'll be fun when I come to write the review and people realise, people are kind of not agreeing with me as I write it, but there we go. That's what reviews are for, isn't it? Walt Disney did it. I don't know who he is. Yeah, maybe. Where's your ring, mate? I think it's on PS4 and PC as well, I think. There's a bird in it. Yeah, shove your record up your arse. Not really sure why I did that, to be honest. Okay. What are you doing here, fucking baby-faced assassin? Fuck. Fuck did I do? Why am I being let out? Your fucking baby faced eyes around that, mate. Is that some sort of sting operation where I pretended to be jailed? Keanu Reeves giving me a cactus. Yeah, I'm pretty lost. So I'm basically making my way up the ranks of the FBI by screwing over all my workmates. Getting friendly with them all, turning my back on them all. And then getting depressed in the process, because I'm screwing over everyone I work with. This guy's a dick. A lot of stuff that happened on one Saturday. Oh, I'm the fucking big cheese now. What happened to Babyfaced? And that's why they're cheering me, is that I'm... Oh no, I'm giving someone else the badge now. Oh, what, so the actual important one I was trying to solve at the start is unsolved? Yeah, that was way back at the start. Team Shortcut, I think we've just about finished it now. You've pretty much missed the whole game. I don't get the significance of that. The fuck? Yeah, it's been archived. Okay. I'm not really sure what to add to this. I bet there's a fucking buffalo at the end of this or something. There's a big massive bird at the end that goes meow, and then that'll be the credits. Heads up. The door to that house. Thank you. No, it doesn't. Team Shortcut, don't worry. Good job, Dick. Mate, you could have glued that bit back on. The photo that comes out is a confused face. That's what I had. Jake. Really? It's fucking single P. I've never done drugs in my life, and even I'm starting to have my doubts. The baby-faced guy's sad. Kill him for finding him cheating. Still love the music though. Who the fuck is this? Mr. Cosby, you're under arrest. I'm so lost now. I thought I was kind of on track of things. Of course, it was aliens. That explains it all. And that's why he's missing, because he got abducted by aliens. Mate, you might be in jail, I don't even know what's going on anymore. We take a screenshot of that because it's a pretty prominent image in the game. There's the prick. Never mind. What in the world of fuck? Well, that was an experience. That was an experience. I love that music though. Well, what to say? Stick to the end of this in case something happens at the end. I wouldn't put it past it. Alright, see you in a bit, Will. I really like that. I mean, I can appreciate how a lot of people... I've not read any reviews or anything about that, but I would imagine a lot of people are angry at that game because it's so fucking confusing. But I really liked it, so... So have some of that. Yeah, I could tell you're angry, but you're going mental all the way through it. I liked it. There's a lot of it I didn't like. This is stuff I'm going to have to think about before I start the review, so there's going to be like a period of reflection, as knobby as that sounds. Once this bit ends, it's weird. I liked it, but there were still obviously criticisms, obviously... confusing as fuck. No kind of absolutely no scope for decision at any point in the entire game. It was one big basically press A to continue cutscene, so that was a bit weird, but it looked amazing, it sounded incredible. It was massively confusing, but I wonder if with a few repeat plays it'll start to make a bit of sense. It seems like the sort of game, there's probably loads of forums and shit with people arguing about what it means, which I'll maybe delve into once the review's written. I don't want it to kind of influence my review in any way, because if I'd been reviewing this before it came out, then I wouldn't have been exposed to any of that debate or anything like that, so you can't really kind of look back at it now. But I liked it. I mean, for what it costs, for $7.99, it was certainly more compelling than a lot of films. It made no sense, but a lot of my favourite films make no sense. Yeah, there we go. That was an experience to say the least. So let me just check my Twitter while these credits are going. I think it's worth keeping the credits to the end just in case. Just in case. So yeah, it was what it was, wasn't it? Yeah, I'll maybe stream some a bit more on this time. But to be honest, I've not. I didn't know what it was going to be like, so there we go. Well, I don't really know what to say about that. Except that was exciting. I enjoyed it. I mean, I'm happy with it. I'm wary of streaming games that have just come out. I'll definitely still review it. But if a game's literally just come out, I don't want to spoil the entire game for people who haven't even had a chance to play it yet. This has been out nearly a year now or something like that, so I don't mind kind of playing through something like this. I don't like the idea of streaming the entirety of a game, especially when it's Thimbleweed Park, especially if it's one that's full, let's fucking chucking achievements at me here, especially one that's like plot based. I don't like spoiling an entire game like that right after it's come out. So if I was ever to do Thimbleweed Park, it'd be a year or two from now. I mean, I'll review it properly, just normally, but not streaming the whole thing. What were the achievements there? She just says thank you. These achievements are really weird as well. There are no passengers on Spaceship Earth, we are all crew. Bits like that annoy me. That's a wee bit pretentious. See, how am I supposed to figure out what I'm supposed to do there? Look at that. That's just crazy talk. Anyway, there we go. That was Virginia. Press A to take a trip. Indeed. Oof. Take a note of that actually, because that's maybe another way to get into it. Right, so what we're going to do, I'm going to cut the stream just for now because I want to split this into two parts basically, the part of me playing the game and then the part of me writing the review. I'm going to stop the stream, go and grab a drink and stuff like that, and I'll be back in like 5 minutes with the second part of the stream where the actual review writing process kicks in. I'll do another tweet and that, tell people that's about where we're at now and that's where we're going to go. Just so that in the future when people want to rewatch this, they don't need to forward 2 hours and see the writing bit. If people are only interested in how I write, they can kind of come later on and see that bit. It'll be on the site split into two different videos, so yeah, bear with me. Let me cut the stream for now. Stick around if you want to see the review process. Give me 5 minutes and I will be back, okay? So thanks so far, but yeah, bear with me, just give me 5 minutes and I'll start the stream again. I'll put a message in the Twitch chat when I start the stream, so that you know whether to refresh or something, just in case that's what you need to do. But otherwise, I will see you in 5 minutes. Cool, back in a sec.